Alright, hello everybody. This is Jen here with you, girl, as usual. Ready to get started in the wee hours of the morning. I was going to start my video yesterday when I got off of work, 4 o'clock in the morning. Your girl was just too tired to do it. So, I am down here now in what I call my office, and I am about to get started. As you can see, I have put some paints out. These are the colors I think that I'm going to be using. I'm not a mixologist, so I don't really know what the heck I'm doing. So, I'm going to give it a shot and see if I can make this thing that I did the other night look beautiful. I put a little bit of red on here already just to try to see if I can get the right color for my cherries. And as you can see, when I painted it black the other night, I let it sit for a couple of days to dry. And you can see that it has cracked a little bit, but that's okay. Also, the fact that I use Play-Doh, I don't really know which one it is. I'm over 50-something years old. Who cares? But anyway, the moisture in the Play-Doh has gone out and it has gotten dry now. So where it was a little thicker when I first made everything, it is now dry and it has thinned out a bit. So as you can see, my grapes have gone from nice bite sizes to little mini sizes. And so has my cherries, and my vines have gotten a little thinner, a little smaller. So that's probably just because the moisture has gone out. And as you can see, some of the purple in the purple clay, just where I wasn't really able to get with the brush to get all of the paint in there, which is why spray paint would have worked better. So I have to make sure that the next time I go to the store, I get some spray paint so that I can do my projects right. But anyway, I'm about to get started painting it and try to see what I can make it look like. So I'm going to let you start off a little bit watching me do some of the painting, and maybe you can see some of the mistakes that I'm sure I'm going to make in the process, because as I've said, I'm not a mixologist, I'm not a painter, none of that, and I really have no idea what I'm doing. So I'm just kind of making it up as I go along, and I'm letting you all come along for the ride with me. So I've already started making a mess with paint and ain't painted nothing yet but my fingers and a little bit of my paper right here. Got some paint on it, so I'm trying to get that out the way before I get it all over my arm and whatnot. So what I'm going to do, choose a brush and try to start painting something. So I think I'm going to start right here with this cherry. If you guys can see what I'm doing, putting a little bit of red on the cherry. I don't know if this is the perfect color for a cherry, so maybe I might have to go back over it, try to mix up another color. I don't know. I'm definitely look like I'm going to have to do more than one coat, because I can still see the black. And once I get all of this painted, I don't want to see black. I want to see nice vibrant colors, but I want them to be the colors that I intend for it to be. So paint this once or twice and hope it turns out nice. Didn't intend for that to rhyme, but it kind of did. Sounded kind of corny too, I guess. So. It ain't looking too bad, but it ain't looking too good either. Guess for the first time trying to do bottle art. Just go through the process of making mistakes and trial and error and all of that until I figure it out. There's some pitiful looking cherries right at the moment, ladies and gentlemen. I certainly wouldn't want to eat them. But like I said, once I get this process down pat and figure out how to use this paint, I'm certainly no Keith Jr., no Bruce Watts, no Picasso, nobody like that. I'm just me, a girl who loves to do arts and crafts, sitting at the table trying to figure it out. Yeah. Still, we're gonna need more than one coat for sure. And I'm gonna have to make some more paint, which is, to me, not a fun part of the process. So that's a couple of the cherries painted. I got a couple of more over here. Definitely smaller than they were when I first rolled them up and glued them on here, but I've already explained that. The Clay-Doh dried out and shrunk them right up. So, make sure I get back in here in these little crevices back here. Get underneath here too. So I'm going to get some color on here, and then once it dries, I'll go back over it again with a second and third coat, because obviously it's going to need it. This black is coming through real strong. There's another cherry or two, and here's one up here. There's two up here with a grape sitting right on top. Remember that grape I told y'all I dropped in the glue? Sitting right there on top. Uh-oh, I painted some of my vine red. Do y'all a favor and not try to sing these songs that you hear in the background, because if I do, you most certainly will stop watching me. I am not a singer. Hardly like to listen to myself. So, there's a couple of cherries just for a little pop of red on there. Okay, I'm gonna put a little purple on here before I go ahead and pause this video and come back. Get these grapes back purple. Wanting to dip my brush in the red again. Not that it would really be much wrong with it, try to get a little bit of red in the purple grapes, but red is not the color I want right at the moment. I gotta get some more purple here. But I'm gonna go ahead and pause it right now. I don't want my video to get too long before I get done with this, and then I'll come back and show y'all what it's looking like. Alright? Right, putting a little bit of green on the leaves here. I see I forgot a cherry up here, so I'm going to grab that here pretty soon when I get back to my red painting brush. In the meantime, I got the green going on the leaves. get another coat on these ones because they're looking sad right about at the moment. Everything is going to need multiple coats. Right now it's looking a bit generic. It'll come together, and I think once it's all done and I put some shellac on it, shine it all up, that's gonna help. And get some leaves going on up here. Definitely get rid of all the white that I see showing through here, and the black for sure. Get me some more paint. Definitely need some more green. One of these days, maybe I'll take an art class or something and learn how to really paint, really draw, and all the stuff that I really like to do, all the stuff that comes naturally. I'm sure I could do better, but I need a little coaching, little classes, a little help on all of that type of stuff. Because even when I draw, I don't do a lot of shading and sculpturing and whatever else is involved in really doing a good job at drawing. I can draw just good enough to make it look like what it's supposed to look like. But there's always that step further that you go with it to make it really look 3D. I don't go that far with it. There's a lot of people that I know of, a few people that I know personally who can do that, my son being one of them, but I'm not that girl. I do just enough. And just like with this, it's going to be just good enough to be pretty, but it ain't going to be good enough to be great, because I'm really not good at mixing paint colors and all that type of stuff. So it's going to be just all right, if I do say so myself. All right, I'll be back. What I got right now. Alright, I'm going to give the green a little chance to dry a little bit because that black is showing through real good on that green. The purple did a lot better. The red didn't do as good as the purple, but it's coming through real strong on the green. So I'm going to start down here and see. I don't know if I want to use the brown or the metallic. So I'm going to start with the brown. If I don't like it, then I'll switch over to the metallic. And I can tell you right now, not feeling the brown. So I'm probably going to just finish painting the whole thing brown because I don't have a whole lot of the metallic paint. And then I'll go over the brown with like a sponge or something to get some of the metallic over top of it. So, be back. So right now, I'm having a little dilemma. I don't know whether to leave this part black or paint it gold, or whether to leave these black or paint them gold. So, this is what the bottom turned out looking like with the brown on it. So, I don't know quite yet what I'm going to do with that. But, I'll figure it out. I'll be back. Okay, so I have decided to leave this area here black, and that way my vines that I painted gold pops out. I put just a dab of gold with the sponge on my cherries and my grapes, just so a little bit of gold shows through. I don't know if I want to leave that much on my grapes. I may try to fix that. I'm not feeling that right now, so I got to work on this area a little bit. I'm going to leave the leaves alone right now because I think if I keep on messing with them, I'm going to mess them up. I'm really not happy with them, but excuse me. But I'm just going to leave them alone because if I mess them up, I'm not going to really know how to fix them. And then the bottom, not too happy with them, but again, I really don't know how to fix that. So I'm just going to kind of leave it alone. Sometimes giving it a day or two, an idea may come, and then you'll be like, oh, that's what I can do with that. And so I'll ponder what I could do to fix this, and then maybe later I'll come back and be able to work on it and have a good idea that will fix it. So now all I'm going to do is just I'm going to clean up my paint lines where the gold, you see gold in here, that's on the black. I'm just going to take a little small paintbrush and come in here and clean up that gold. I don't want to see messy gold on my black. I want everything to be as crisp and neat as possible. So that's what I'm doing now. Just kind of going around, fixing all the areas that look sloppy like that. So I can fix all of that up a little bit. Very tedious, time consuming. And so when I get done fixing all of that up, making sure all my gold is not shining through down here on my black, I'll do the same thing down here in this area. I don't want to see all this gold where it should be black. So I'm just going to fix all of that up so everything can be nice and crisp and neat. But other than that, there are certain little other areas that I'm not going to worry about too much, especially like if you can see on the leaves and even on the cherries and whatnot where it's not perfect. It's okay. It doesn't have to be perfect. It actually looks a little antique, and so that gives it a little bit of character. So you don't have to have it all, you know, filled in with paint. You can see other, you know, spots and colors and cracks and stuff shining through. And that's okay. So, that's just the way it's going to be. So, for now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to pause it one more time. And then I'll come back to you. Alright, so this is about as good as it's going to get. If I keep messing with it, I'm probably going to mess it up. So I'll put a little bit of shellac on it tomorrow, make it shine, and this will be it for the bottle, I think. Like I said, maybe, I don't know. I'm going to leave it alone. Good night, everybody.